Hello and welcome to this series of reflections. Today, Christ is born, praying with the icon of the Holy Nativity. My name is Brother James, and we're here in the chapel of the Monastery of the Society of St. John the Evangelist in Cambridge, Massachusetts. I want to turn our attention now to this scene down at the bottom of the icon, troubled Joseph. Joseph here in the icon is depicted away from the central action. The action, of course, is up here around the shepherds, the angels, the virgin, the child, and down here, kind of out of the way, out of the action, is Joseph. Tired, dejected, troubled. Troubled Joseph. We know from Matthew's gospel that Joseph was troubled. Joseph had his doubts. Now, the birth of Jesus the Messiah took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived of her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife, but had no marital relations with her until she had borne a son, and he named him Jesus. We see there two men speaking with Joseph, and we saw them both a few moments ago. These are the two shepherds from the earlier scene over here. But this time something is different. This time, they are not here in the icon to tell good news, but to cast doubts. And we see that with the crooked staff. Here, the staff is bent and twisted to cast doubt about the truth. Doubt comes to us in various guises. Sometimes doubt comes to us dressed in the familiar. Sometimes doubt comes to us in the form of truth that has been slightly twisted. Joseph, Matthew tells us, is a good man, even a righteous man, and yet he has his doubts. Even Joseph is troubled. What troubles you? Don't be afraid of them. Don't be afraid of those things which trouble you. Instead, allow God to hear your troubles. Allow God to hear your doubts. Allow God to hear what concerns you. And then listen to God. Listen to God. And God, who is truth, I am the way, the truth, and the life. God, who is truth, will speak truth. Gerard Manley Hopkins wrote a poem based on St. Thomas Aquinas's hymn, Godhead Here in Hiding. Godhead here in hiding, whom I do adore, masked by these bare shadows, shape and nothing more. See, Lord, at thy service, low lies here a heart, lost, all lost in wonder at the God thou art. Seeing, touching, tasting are in thee deceived. How, says trusty hearing, that shall be believed? What God's Son has told me, take for truth I do. Truth himself speaks truly, or there's nothing true. Truth himself speaks truly, or there's nothing true. So spend some time in company with troubled Joseph. Allow yourself to speak your troubles aloud to God. Allow yourself to speak your doubts to God. Keep company with troubled Joseph. And hear how God speaks truly to you. Do not be afraid, for the child conceived is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Truth himself speaks truly, or there's nothing true. Allow God to speak God's truth to you. You are mine. I love you. I hold you in my hand. Keep company with Joseph. Speak your troubles and listen for God's truth. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.